might be digging in our bags, or we might be fixing, planning our schedule for the grocery, or we might be doing all kinds of other things while the announcements are being made. And then when people ask you, are you going to this one? They say, what are you talking about? We never know, we never know. So I'm repeating so that if you ever say you didn't know, you hear that someone here tonight, you will pay for it, eh? Okay. Now, the Anglican world, 165 plus countries, is involved in a process of intentional discipleship. And that is because a group called the Anglican Consultative Council met in Zambia in 2016. They passed 45 resolutions. And the number one resolution was that the communion should engage in a process of intentional discipleship. Because it was felt the church does quite a lot of work, but it is not intentional in making its members disciples. And I think Father Grange hit the spot here tonight with his delivery, because they were not advocating that we go anywhere and make anybody anything. But they were saying, if we make disciples intentionally, others will see what is happening and will join us. That's the plan. That's what I heard Father Grange to begin with. The plan.
Yeah.
That's the plan. So that if we are disciples and we intentionally follow after Jesus and seek to do and watch and do and watch and help and so forth, then that movement creates its own momentum, and we have the energy and power and strength of the church in action. Not just the Anglican church, but the church. If you look at the past couple weeks or so, and Assemblyman Farley Augustine, once my student, of whom I am justly proud, and I used to tell him, if you remember, you know, I said, we don't have mayors in Tobago, but probably you're going to be a mayor of one of those places soon. And that was some years before we got into all what is happening here now. Because he was always outspoken, he always had a point of view, and he always challenged the system. And so whatever is happening now is not a new matter. But what I want to celebrate is, whatever his family's religion, didn't matter. It was the Anglican church, the Anglican school, Bishop Anstey High School, working with all the people who come under its banner to empower all the people of God, whatever is the religious group, to make them solid citizens of this country and of the kingdom of God. Amen. That's the mandate and mission of the church. Very, very serious mission. And if you look at them, we're probably taking a little dig here now. Last Monday, when you looked at the savant, the president, the prime minister, the chief justice, the work of the Anglican Church in Trinidad and Tobago. Holy Bishop. So what I'm saying is, we have been doing our part and playing our role in this country, not looking for any special reward. And I want to commend you in your adherence to the process and the system. Because it's not only for us. We had a great archbishop who said, the church is the only organization that does not exist for its own members. Think about that. The only organization that does not exist for its own members. In other words, we are not to That's not it. We will minister and respond to all who will accept our ministry. That's what we do in our schools. When schools then used to take the HIV and AIDS positive children, the Anglican schools used to take them. Well, now it's distributed around. But the children of the Sierra Ross home, they only went to Anglican schools at a certain time. Because other schools said, no, we don't want those AIDS children here. But that is the essence of our ministry. So all the religious groups have a role to play in the country. All the people have a role to play, and our role must be to build this country and make it strong and to ensure we are on the path leading to the kingdom of God. That's what we have done a little bit of here tonight. Thank you very much for coming out. Do get home safely, and let us continue to do our little bit in all corners wherever we are. And for that sacrifice, God will remain well pleased for the work that we continue to do. So let us stand for the final.